morning, good afternoon, good night, wherever you are. Welcome to my channel. My name is Carissa. Hit that subscribe button and turn on post notifications because I post every Saturday. A few videos back, I did like a girl talk video and I told you guys to ask me like some juicy, embarrassing questions, like literally anything you wanted to, and you guys loved it. And I'm so happy because I loved it too. So I figured I would do another one. So on my Instagram story, I told you guys to ask me more dirty, embarrassing, juicy, sex, like all kinds of questions, and you guys delivered. There are some very interesting questions on there. I'm just gonna go about my day. I have some things to do. These questions are gonna be a lot more, like the first video I did, it was pretty juicy. This is like a whole nother level of juicy. So get your popcorn ready. It's gonna be a juicy one. I'm so tired. I did like a 2-hour workout yesterday and I'm dead. Before I get started, I'll tell you guys like what I'm doing today. I am gonna go home to like my hometown, which is not that far away, my parents' house. And then I'm gonna have some coffee with one of my childhood friends. We've been friends for years, like years. She's one of my closest friends. So I'm gonna go see her. We'll get her involved in the questions. And then I have a little appointment that I'll explain to you when the time comes. And I'm kind of nervous for it, so I'm gonna bring you guys along with me for some comfort, for some moral support. So I was looking through these questions and I was gonna like organize them a little bit, but they're just like all over the place. Like look, I screenshotted them. There's so many. I'll do like 3 right now. Okay, I'm gonna start with this one because I feel like a lot of people not struggle with it, but like I talk about this all the time with my friends. You know, okay, anyways. Biggest tip on how to lose lower pouch belly fat. We're just diving right in. For me, I struggle with this too. It's just stubborn is all hell. I would always be embarrassed of it, but then it's like, you got some good important things in there that your body's protecting. So I think it's kind of important to have a little bit of something there. It is really stubborn. Guys that I've been with love to just grab it. I don't know why, and I'm always like, don't touch me there. This is my no-no zone, my belly fat. Just own it. Literally, I own it. And I just think of it as your body is protecting all your organs. If you really want to slim it down, then I guess like diets, running, ab workouts, there's things you could do. But like, I've tried a lot and mine just stay in there and I've learned to love it. Another one. A lot of people were asking, do girls shave or wax down there? Another one was asking about like how to avoid like razor bumps on the bikini line. I've never waxed, I'm scared of waxing. I waxed my eyebrows one time and it like ripped off part of my skin and I broke out like really bad. So I'm scared of waxing. I learned a tip when I was in high school, and if you put like a little bit of deodorant, just like one little on the bikini line, then it really helps like after you shave, and it kind of helps with the razor burn. It helps me at least. If you're interested in like laser hair removal, go through Groupon and you can get it for really cheap and it helps a lot. Okay, I'll do one more question before I have to get dressed. What is your type? This is funny because I used to have such a specific like look wise type, and now I don't. Now I have like a bigger, broader type. Honestly, it might sound cheesy, but I look for like personality traits now. You gotta have a job, you know, stuff like that, blah, blah, blah. But I love people who are like super confident, but not in like a cocky douchebag way, you know, like someone who's like outgoing. And I'm kind of a shy person. It may not seem like it, but I am. So I like someone who's like not shy at all. And they kind of just like take charge. They're like loud, outgoing, that kind of like vibe. Someone who carries themselves well, dresses well, has their shit together. I really like tattoos. Yeah. Okay, I'm gonna go get dressed because I have to leave now. Okay, I'm putting on my shoes right now. Why do boys have to ask the most disgusting questions? I got a lot of good questions from girls, but boys, what are you thinking? I said, ask me some, you know, dirty questions and stuff, but there is a limit to what you ask a woman. My lord! To answer the most common question that the boys ask, I will not be making an OnlyFans. So you can get that out of your head and go find someone else's. Do you guys run late, or is that just me? Like, I was fully on time, and then it's like I do something and somehow I'm always late. Even if I get up on time, like whatever, like I'm always 5 minutes late to everything. I don't get it, but it is what it is. This weather can't make up its mind. 2 days ago it was pouring rain, freezing cold. I got out all of my winter outfits because I was like, yes, it's boot season, like I'm gonna rock my coats and everything. It's like 88 degrees outside and I'm sweating. That's why you can probably hear my air conditioning. I can't turn it off, so I'm sorry if it's loud. It's so hot.
Now I was telling you guys I'm like always late. I literally lost my phone for like multiple minutes after I stopped filming. It was just on my bathroom counter, but like I literally couldn't see it. It was like invisible even though it was right in front of me. So little things like that where it's just like, I have no explanation. Okay, I got this one a lot and it is an awkward topic. I feel like for a lot of people, so I'll just be the person to answer it. Like, people are asking, do you think masturbation is wrong? No, I think it's extremely healthy and extremely normal. My sex drive skyrockets when I'm on my period. Are you the same way or am I weird? No, honey. Your hormones are all over the place, so that is extremely normal. I've talked about it with my friends. It's just, it is what it is. Like, the human body is very interesting, so that is extremely normal. Like, I'm raging with hormones in all kinds of ways when I'm on my period, so you are not weird, you are normal. A lot of you are asking about, like, your first time, like, losing your V-card. Is it painful? How to prepare for your first time? If you're nervous? Someone said that they're talking to a boy who's ready for it, but they aren't ready. Let me just start off by saying, if you aren't ready, or if you're too nervous or a little uncomfortable, then don't do it. You do it when you are fully ready and you, like, want it, you know? Don't do it because someone else is ready. Do it when you are ready and the other person is ready. Yes, it hurts the first time, the first few times it hurts. It's just, you know, it is painful. I'll just straight up say it. On that note, I'm gonna drive home and then we'll answer some more juicy questions, but I'm excited to go get a coffee. I'm going to eat my meal prep on the way home. We got chicken, brown rice, and asparagus, and I made a bunch of these. I think it's helpful to like make your meals like at the beginning of the week or in the middle of the week and just have a bunch of them ready, because then like you could just grab it when you're hungry rather than like, I don't know, I get lazy with cooking too, so having this ready, it helps me like avoid Postmates and stuff like that. So I'll eat healthy if it's like made and ready to go. I could eat healthy all day long, but it's a matter of like cooking it. So I usually dedicate a few hours on like Sunday to like cook everything and then I'm good. There's a dog hair on my face and I can't figure out where it is. Ah! Just dropped Max off at my parents and then I'm going to go meet my friend for some coffee before my appointment, which is in like 2 hours. But I wanted to tell you guys something that happened to me yesterday because it was so just like gross. So yesterday Danielle and I were at the beach. We were in Laguna Beach. So is the camera really shaky? So it's a very small beach and there's like cliffs everywhere. The cliffs aren't like unreachable, like there's trails to go up on the cliffs and stuff. Each red light is like when I'm gonna continue telling the story. There's like houses up on these cliffs and all apartments. So there's like balconies that look over the beach and the cliffs and the ocean. Like you could get like a panorama of everything. We were down on the beach in our bathing suits, taking photos, you know, doing our thing. And this lady is like on her balcony and she's like motioning me to come over. And I'm like, oh great, it's a Karen. Like, I don't know. I didn't know what she wanted. So I go over there because she's literally like waving and she's like, come here. And I was like, okay. So I went over and she's like, there's a man over there on that cliff and he's in the bushes with a zoom and he's zooming in on his camera taking photos of you. I was like, ew. And Danielle and I were like, let's go get him. Both of us like are just so like strong and independent now that we don't take shit from anyone. So I was like, he's not gonna do that and get away with it. So when I tell you, we marched up that cliff because there's like a little trail to get up there and he's like speed walking away and we were like, hey, hey, and he's like ignoring us, pretending he can't hear. And I was like, hey, I will put up a photo of this man right here. And we were like, you know, it's not cool to be taking photos of people. It's like extremely pervy. Hold on, wait till we're stopped. we're talking to the guy and we were like, you know, it's not cool to be taking photos of us. Like, we literally, that lady saw you taking photos. I saw you in the bushes, literally in the bushes, taking our photo. And I was like, that's not cool. And he was like, when I tell you he was so pervy and gross, he was like, I wasn't taking your photo. And I was like, okay, let's see the photos then. Let's see it. Your camera's right there. Turn it on. Let's see. Prove to us that we're not on your camera roll. And he was like, oh, my camera's dead. Like, oh, when I tell you I was getting ready to stop this motherfucker, oh my God. I was like, goodbye, perv, like, whatever, I don't know. I just, how annoying is that to be a female on the beach doing your thing and there's a freaking perv in the bushes taking photos of you on his zoom lens camera? Gross. I was so grossed out and I was like, I'm putting my shorts on and I want to sit under the umbrella now. He ruined it. Ladies and gentlemen, always be like, I don't know, it's so annoying. I can't have like a normal beach day without some dude ruining it. Like, I was so annoyed and I will forever be annoyed. So here's his photo once again. Perv, perv, perv. But that is my creepy story time of Mr. Pervy Man, and cut to me getting some coffee.
Did you try it already?
Yeah, I don't know.
I hope it's not too loud. Good question. You're making me nervous.
Have you ever fallen off the bed while having sex?
I've never fallen off. I am pretty balanced.
Yes, you.
You haven't? If you have, comment down below and let's talk about that. Who's your celebrity crush?
Like the Hemsworth brothers, they're really cute.
Ryan Reynolds.
Yeah, that's a good one.
I really like Ryan. Another question was like, nice guy or bad boy?
I like bad boys, but I need to like the nice guys.
You have like someone who like looks like he could be a bad boy,
but he's like a nice guy.
He has tattoos, yeah. So it's like,
but he's like a nice person.
Yeah, he's a little nice sweetheart.
That's what I need.
Yeah,
bad looking boy.
But nice on the inside.
Favorite position.
Yeah, I don't have a favorite position.
Mine is all of them.
Let's get specific. Oh, do I have any red flags? I read that in the car. I don't have any. And I was like, that's a big red flag.
I throw some bleach on the red flag
and
turn it pink.
Think about
it. It's a big pink flag.
Like, is it my own red flag or red flags that I like?
Like, okay, like, let's say you went on a date and like some guy did something and you're like, not about it.
They make me pay. You know, like the awkward moment where you're like, you're taking out your like wallet because you're gonna be like polite. They don't even take theirs out. They go, thanks.
Okay, yeah, but I feel like that's happened to you a lot, so that's why it's
you meet someone for the first time and they talk bad about other people.
That's a good one.
That's a red flag.
I see red flags and I like, it's like a moth to a flame. I just, I don't know, this bad.
I just realized I never introduced you.
It's Marissa.
I'm Marissa.
I'm Carissa.
We're best friends.
So we've known each other since like third grade. We've been like really good friends since like seventh grade.
Have no filter,
no judgment.
No filter, no judgment. We
love to eat. We're gonna have girl talk off camera and then I will cut to my appointment.
So now I'm on my way to my appointment. I'm gonna be going to Ageless. I am going to be getting lip filler. The last time I did it was July 2020, so over a year ago. So my lips, I don't know, this is like my own weird thing where I like getting lip filler. It's my own insecurity. I've been to a couple different places, but this one lady at Ageless, like, I loved the way she did my lips last time, so I'm going back to her. Highly recommend the work she does, but I'm kind of scared because like the recovery of lip injections is like hardcore. Like, it's a lot to handle. Your lips bruise, they swell so bad, and they're like stiff. So I look like a Botox monster after I get it for like a couple days. So I'm kind of nervous, but that's why I'm bringing you guys along for moral support. And I'll film the process just in case you guys are like curious about it. But if you don't like needles, then look away. Okay, I am in the room. Got a cute little ring light, so we have good lighting. And I'm just waiting for Amy, and I signed my paperwork, and I'm excited. I think I'm gonna make a reels about it too, because it's intriguing. I feel like a lot of girls are like curious about it, but don't know where to go, or like what it's gonna look like, or the process. So I'm just kinda gonna inform everybody about what the process is like.
Can turn this bad boy. Okay, that's why.
I feel like your lip, bottom lip is still really good. I think we focused on your top lip last time.
Yeah, just like I like when it's like
in the middle and lips up.
Yeah.
Okay, the little two pockets, mm-hmm. two little nice puffy.
All right, so the numbing cream is on and we're gonna wait about 20 minutes. My lips are already feeling numb. Some of the numbing cream got on my tongue. I was just on FaceTime and I was drooling.
So today we're gonna use a little bit of Juvederm Ultra, which is perfect for lips. It gives really good volume. For Krista, we're gonna kind of focus here in the centers of her lips, give her lips some nice volume. Give her a nice little bit of flip up and then focus right in the center. Give her two nice little pockets here on the bottom. Give a little ice.
Oh my god, it's so pretty. It's so pretty.
Good little bit of flip.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I know you're numb and it's gonna feel weird, but smile for me. You're perfect.
That's so cute.
It looks really cute on you.
I know.
That's so pretty. Thank you.
Good?
Yeah.
Okay.
I love it.
Yay.
All right, so these are my lips right after. I'm still really numb, so I'm gonna let the numbness like wear off. All right, it's been like 2 days since I did the lip filler. My lips are still really like swollen and stiff, so I probably look a little funny because I still can't like move my mouth normally. I put like lip stuff on so you can't really see, but I am bruising like right here and then like here. But all this is like still swollen, but it's gonna go down a lot. I remember the last time I did this, it took like, honestly, like a week and a half for it to be fully like normal and where I could like look normal too. But they don't really hurt anymore. Yesterday I was struggling because it was like so swollen and so stiff and I was just icing my lips all day, but it's getting better and I'm liking the shape of them a lot. And Ageless actually gave me a code to give to you guys, which is get 10% off, which I think is incredible. So I'll put the code right here. I am just chilling today. I've been like hibernating because I don't want to go anywhere with my lips like this. I will answer one more question before I end the vlog here. Also, I wanted to say that I am going to New York in a few days, so I'm so excited. I haven't gone literally anywhere in like 2-3 years maybe. Oh my god, it's been like 3 years since I've gotten on a plane, so I'm really nervous, but I'm excited. So prepare for a New York City vlog. I'm going with a bunch of my friends, so I'm excited. I don't know what's gonna happen there, but we'll see. So I know like this whole video I did a lot of like really dirty questions because it's fun. I think dirty questions are so fun and entertaining and it's like fun to talk about. But I'm gonna end this on like a cute question. What is your love language? I would definitely say I am words of affirmation girl. I do love like little, what is the other one? Gift giving or get something with gifts, but not like real like nice presents. I love like little things. But like for me personally, I would always get like post-it notes and I would write little, just like little things like I love this about you or something like, and I would do a bunch of them and I put them in places that I know the person would find throughout their day without expecting it. Just like little things like that. That's kind of like a gift and words of affirmation in one, but I like to give that and I like to receive that. Hearing like nice things about you or saying nice things about someone is like really special. I don't know, I love that. So that's kind of my love language. Comment down below what your love language is. I'd love to know. The next time you see me, my lips will not be swollen and bruised and stiff. And I'll be in New York. I love New York. My entire life, I've always wanted to go there and I've been there a couple times. I think the last time I was there was for New York Fashion Week. So it'll be so fun to go back and just like strut the town, and it's gonna be cold. So I have some really good like outfits with big coats and boots and stuff, so I'm excited. So stay tuned, but thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video. I hope you got a good laugh. Thank you guys so much for being so kind and supportive. Let me know if you guys wanna see more videos like this. I love doing little girl talk Q&As. I think it's so fun. Please subscribe and turn on post notifications, and I will see you next Saturday.